Mood Indigo has been labeled Duke Ellington's first big hit. The song is essentially a blues. It comes from Ellington's period at the Cotton Club in Harlem in 1927, 1929, when Ellington went through a divorce. Like many other blues, Mood Indigo tells the truth about some of the symptoms of the human condition. Heartache, pain, loss. Martin Luther, who himself knew a thing or two about the experience of heartache, said, "But where there is true prayer, there must be utter earnestness. We must feel our need, the distress that drives and impels us to cry out. Then prayer will come spontaneously, as it should, and no one will need to be taught how to prepare for it or how to create the proper devotion." The blues often tell the truth about heartache, pain, and loss, and in this instance, Mood Indigo's melancholy minor chords are the structure around which the musician spontaneously prays or improvises. Ellington wrote that every person prays in their own language, and there is no language that God does not understand. He went on, "I believe that no matter how highly skilled a drummer or saxophonist might be, if this is the thing he does best, and he offers it sincerely from the heart in or as accompaniment to his worship, he will not be unacceptable because of lack of skill or the instrument upon which he makes his demonstration, be it pipe or tom-tom." Put another way, Luther said in the Large Catechism, "For God does not regard prayer on account of the person, but on account of his word and the obedience accorded to it." He went as far to say, "Next to the word of God, the noble art of music is the greatest treasure in the world." Prayer, including in its form as music, is powerful. Ellington's musical prayers helped change the way we understand sacred and secular music. Ellington premiered three sacred concerts in 1965, 1968, and 1978 that were performed in a church. Jana Tull-Steed said Ellington's prayers led a movement that redefined the settings in which jazz was deemed acceptable. He brought what some called the devil's music into the sanctuary and reclaimed its sacred origins. Similarly, Ellington's hymn, "Come Sunday," is numbered among the company of those by Isaac Watts, the Wesleys, Martin Luther, in the United Methodist Hymnal. Ellington's musical prayers broke down barriers between how we perceive the boundaries of sacred and secular. He changed which prayers or music were acceptable in church settings. God hears our prayers, so let us pray.
Could cry, 'cause 'cause there's nobody who cares about me. I'm just a soul who's bluer than blue can be. When I get that mood indigo, I could lay me down and die. You shoes while I sleep.